What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, we got some interesting news, man. Undefeated, rising, welterweight, superstar boxer, Jaron Boots Ennis, has some interesting take regarding the upper echelon of the welterweight division. If you don't know, Jaron Boots Ennis is 22 years of age. He turns 23 June 26th. So in just a few short weeks, he'll be 23 years of age. He sports a resume. He's 25-0, 23 by way of knockout, right? He's 5'10". He had a 74-inch arm reach. Extremely long arms, right? And the key is he's extremely athletic. With that said, Jaron Boots Ennis talked about the champions in the welterweight division and when will he give his opportunity to face the champions in the welterweight division, right? He doesn't think that, you know, he's going to get his opportunity to face these champions because they know that he's a super high risk with a low reward right now, right? He hasn't fought too many big names in the sport of boxing and in the welterweight division. So with that said, he believes that it's going to be hard for him to get his opportunity. But when breaking the fighters down, two fighters in particular, he broke down undefeated, unified, WBC, IBF, welterweight, world champion, superstar boxer, Earl "The Truth" Spence Jr., and former three-division world champion, former junior welterweight undisputed world champion, and currently WBO welterweight world champion, who's widely recognized within the sport of boxing as the number one pound-for-pound boxer in the world, Terrence Boyd Crawford. He broke down the fact that he says, when it comes to Terrence Crawford, first off, I'll beat both of them. I'll outbox both of them, and I'll outsmart both of them, right? Then he goes on to say, when it comes to Terrence Crawford, yes, he's a very slick boxer, and yes, it will somewhat look like looking in the mirror because our styles are very similar. The difference is I do everything better than him. I'm faster than him. I'm slicker than him. I have a high ring IQ, ring generalship, and I'm stronger than him. I'm bigger than him. That is true, right? And then he says when it comes to Errol Spence, first and foremost, he doesn't even like to talk about in regard to Errol Spence right now due to the fact that he suffered that horrific car accident on October 10th. And he doesn't believe that anybody that fights Errol Spence right now is going to get their just dues. But when it comes to Errol Spence, he says, I'm simply going to outbox Errol Spence and just outsmart Errol Spence. And I'll think him in the ring, point blank and period. He says, so whoever fights him now, they're in a lose-lose situation. We know that former two-division world champion, former WBC welterweight world champion, Danny Swift Garcia, is on the verge of getting the opportunity to fight for the titles and regain his WBC title from Errol Spence Jr., who Sean Porter took it from Danny Garcia, and then Errol Spence took it from Sean Porter in September, September 28th. So with that said, you know, Jaron Ennis believes that he's simply going to outbox and outsmart Errol Spence when it comes to Errol Spence. And when it comes to Terrence Crawford, he's going to do the same thing. He says, because me and Terrence Crawford are very similar, but I do everything better than Terrence Crawford. Wow. Like I said, Jaron Boots Ennis is very big for the welterweight division. He's 5'10". Obviously, he fights at 147. And he has a 74-inch arm reach. So he nearly has a 75-inch arm reach, right? And that's mega in the sport, right? Terrence Crawford is Terrence Crawford has extremely long arms in his own right, you know. But Terrence Crawford is not as big as Jaron Boots Ennis, right? Terrence Crawford, he too has very long arms. Terrence Crawford is 36-0, 27 by way of knockout. He's 5'8", but guess what? Terrence Crawford matches Jaron Ennis in arm reach. He has a 74-inch arm reach in his own right. So, like I said, Terrence Crawford has very long arms as well, right? When you talked about guys like Floyd Mayweather, right? Floyd Mayweather was considered to have very, very long arms for the division for his height. And Floyd Mayweather and Terrence Crawford are very, very similar in stature and arm reach, right? With that said, Errol Spence is 5'9.5". He's nearly 5'10", with a 72-inch arm reach. Errol Spence is 26-0, 21 by way of knockout. So, you know, he has, Jaron Ennis is 25-0, 23 by way of knockout. It's just the difference is the level of opponents that they face. Errol Spence, yes, they have a very similar resume, but Errol Spence is 30 years old. Errol Spence has fought in UK against Kell Brook and took his IBF title. He's fought two-time welterweight world champion Showtime Sean Porter. He's fought a former four-division Mexican world champion superstar boxer Mikey Garcia. He's fought Lamont Peterson, who was a world champion. He's fought Chris Algieri. You understand? So he has fought, you know, big names in the welterweight division. Jerron Ennis has yet to do so, right? But like I said, Floyd Mayweather was considered to have very long arms when it came to the sport of boxing and for his stature. And Floyd Mayweather, like I said, is very similar in his build and his approach to that of Terrence Crawford. Floyd Mayweather is 5'8", you know, but his arm reach is only 72 inches. So Terrence Crawford's arm reach is considered very long, you know, but when you look at it, Jerron Ennis is both 74-inch arm reach. So his Terrence Crawford arm reach is longer than Floyd Mayweather's, right? 2 inches longer. So with that said, you know, he has a height advantage, but he doesn't have the reach advantage over Terrence Crawford. Now, he has the youth advantage, right? Terrence Crawford is going on 33. Jerron Ennis is going on 23. So Terrence Crawford is 10 years his senior. When it comes to Errol Spence, Errol Spence is 30. So Errol Spence is 7 years his senior, right? But Jerron Ennis hits very hard. He's very athletic. He's very skillful. And he does have a high ring IQ. If you put Jerron Ennis in the ring with them right now, seeing as though he hasn't fought a high-profile fight and a high-profile fighter currently, to understand the magnitude of the fight, to understand what it is to be in this with that pressure under the lights. Like Floyd Mayweather said, everybody could do it in the gym. Can you do it under the lights? That's a totally different story. A lot of people freeze up. So we haven't seen Jerron Ennis in that position. So to put Jerron Ennis in the ring with Terrence Crawford, with the Errol Spence currently right now, I don't like it. I think that the difference is going to be, yes, can he match them in athletic ability? Can he match them in physical abilities? Yes. The difference is he can't match them in experience, right? So they know what it takes to be champion. They know what it takes to be unified. They know what it takes to be under the big lights. They know what it takes to be have the magnifying glass on you when you're in those huge fights. They know what it is to have, you know, thousands of people show up at your weigh-in. They know what it takes to have thousands of people showing up at your press conferences. They know what it takes. They know what it feels like. They've been in those moments. I liken it to remember when we had Erickson the Hammer Lubin take on Jermell Charlo, and Jermell Charlo continued to express that it was too early in his career for him to take a fight of this magnitude. Erickson Lubin dared to be great at that point in his time in his career. He was very young. And he went in there and he got knocked out in the first round. He made a mistake early in the fight, and Jermell Charlo, having experience, made him pay for that mistake. Can Erickson Lubin, adjust to that now? I think this will be a totally different fight with Erickson Lubin, this version, who has now had big fight experience and who has been in there with tougher opponents, higher level opponents. And if you put him in the ring with Jermell Charlo now, that would be a 50-50 fight. In the beginning, he could have matched them in athletic ability and physical ability, but he didn't have the experience. And that, I think that would be the same case when it comes to Jerron Ennis and against Terrence Crawford and Errol Spence. Now, if you give him time to build up his resume and get this experience, he needs to be co-main events. He needs to fight more journeymen, right? He needs to fight the Sergey Lipinets of the world. He needs to fight your Danis Ugas, would be a great fight for him. He needs to fight, Chris Algieri. Well, Chris Algieri now campaigning at junior welterweight, but, you know, your Danis Ugas, perfect for me, right? In my opinion. Maybe land a Amir Khan fight. Land a Kell Brook fight if possible. You know, I think he has the ability to beat a Kell Brook right now, even though that would be a high profile, big fight for him. But Kell Brook is not on the level of an Errol Spence and Terrence Crawford currently right now. Kell Brook is more so on the downside of his career. And so that would be the perfect fight for him. fight Figueroa, who's going to give you feedback. You know, like I said, the perfect fight, in my opinion, would be Jordanus Ugas or Sergey Lipinets. You know, that would be the two perfect opponents for me for to see how Jerron Ennis responds to being under the bright lights with all the pressure. Because obviously, if he fights a Jordanus Ugas or a Sergey Lipinets, for one, it's going to be either the main event on this card or it's going to be the co-main event. So with that said, I think that that's the route that he needs to take before looking to jump up and fight a guy like Terrence Crawford and Errol Spence. Can he beat them? Absolutely. Can he beat them right now? I don't know if he could beat them right now due to the lack of experience, right? So I would much rather see him get the experience. But he's very confident. He has the all ability. He has the power, you know. But like I said, we haven't seen him on a big stage in with a high-profile opponent. Jordanus Ugas would be perfect. You know, he just beat Omar Figueroa. You know, a lot of people felt like he won the fight against Sean Porter. You know, I think Sean Porter at this point in time would be too high of a level of a step up. And this is no, I'm not trying to downplay Jerron Ennis and his skill set. But you don't want to put, you don't want to go from the level of opponents that he was fighting right now currently to fighting a guy like Sean Porter, right? Because you need him to face adversity more so than he and being able to deal with it and understand how to deal with it in big moments before you put him in there with a guy like Sean Porter, who's going to bring it to him 24/7 the entire time, the whole 36 minutes of the fight, right? So, you know, let's say he suffers a cut. How is he going to respond to that? You know, let's say he down on the cards. How is he going to respond to that? We need to see him in fights where there's a guy that's on the other side that's at least a 60-40 fight. All of the fights that he's currently had have been 80-20 in his favor. So we need to see him in fights that, you know, that the gap is closed as far as, you know, the chances of his opponents being successful and winning the fight. So we don't want to see him don't put him in there with a Sean Porter. That would be bad business to put him in there with a Sean Porter. And definitely Terrence Crawford, Errol Spence. And he may mention a Manny Pacquiao, but obviously Manny Pacquiao is too far advanced in his career to fight Jerron Ennis, right? That makes no sense. Maybe, like I said, Amir Khan. Let's see Jerron Ennis. And, you know, we got guys like, you know, who's out there that we could see him fight? You know, I love the Jordanus Ugas fight, and I love the Sergey Lipinets fight. You know, you got Austin Trout. How about an Austin Trout fight? Austin Trout is campaigning at 147. He's looking for a big fight. He's looking to make a statement. That would be a perfect fight for Jerron Boots Ennis. Fight Austin Trout. Get an Austin Trout fight done. Like I said, the perfect fight for me, in my opinion, is Sergey Lipinets and Jordanus Ugas. Sergey Lipinets, I believe, is in the running to Sergey Lipinets fought and lost to Mikey Garcia, you know, but he's a rough, rugged opponent. You know, he's 31 years of age. He only has one loss on his resume, that coming at the hands of Mikey Garcia. He's on a three-fight winning streak. He just, I was at the fight when he fought Lamont Peterson. I was very impressed. He stopped Lamont Peterson, you know, and that's a perfect fight, in my opinion, right, is to get Sergey Lipinets, right? He's ranked high in the ranking system. I believe Sergey Lipinets, if I'm not mistaken, is high in the WBO ranking system, if I'm not mistaken. So Sergey Lipinets would be 16-1. You know, Sergey Lipinets is 31 years of age. You know, he's been in there. He's a rough, rugged opponent. Like I said, his only loss is to Mikey Garcia. That would be a perfect opponent. You know, my take is the absolute perfect fit to see where he stands, you know, to judge his skills, and somebody's going to give him feedback and it's going to be a difficult fight for him would be Jordanus Ugas. He's a Cuban fighter. He's 33 years of age, right? Jordanus Ugas is very big as well. He's 25-4, 12 by way of knockout, but that doesn't describe Jordanus Ugas. He's 5'9". His reach is 69-inch arm reach. I think he's definitely bigger than 5'9". I think he's definitely 5'10". Because I think he's slightly bigger than Errol Spence. So, but he's on a two-fight winning streak. He just beat Mike Dallas. He beat Omar Figueroa Jr. And prior to that, he lost to Sean Porter, but a lot of people felt like he won the Sean Porter fight. So Amir Imam, you know, I thought he won the fight against Amir Imam as well, you know. So that would be the meet, and that would be, you know, a slam dunk for Jerron Boots Ennis to measure where he stands, right? And because he's going to match him in skills, size, and strength. And he's hungry, right? So he wants it. You know, Sergey Lipinets, Yordanis Ugas, you know. And like I said, maybe if you could land a Mia Khan fight. You know, like I said, you got Austin Trout. Austin Trout is a journeyman. Austin Trout, you know, Austin Trout brings a lot to the table, right? Austin Trout has been in mega fights, right? He's been in there with Canelo Alvarez. Austin Trout has been in there with, you know, both Jermell and Jamal Charlo, right? He's 32-5-1, 18 by way of knockout. He's been stopped one time in his career. Austin Trout, you know, recently fought Montoya. That was at 140-149. So he's campaigning. He's coming down, right? He's doing the opposite as he gets older. He's 34 years of age. He's a southpaw, 5'9.5". That would give him. He's slick, you know. He has veteranship. He has experience. You get in there with Austin Trout. Austin Trout, like I said, has been in there with both Charlos, Jermell and Jamal. He's been in there with Jerry Hurd. He's been in there with Erislandy Lara. He's been in there with Canelo Alvarez. He's been in there with Miguel Cotto. He beat Miguel Cotto, you know. So he's been in there with some high-profile fighters, and he's been in high-profile fights. He's not that far past it. He's only 34 years of age. And like I said, he's slick with a lot of experience, and he's dedicated to the sport. So he's going to test Jerron Ennis, right, in more ways than one, not just physically but mentally, right? And he's going to, you know, push him to the brink. He's not going to fold. So Austin Trout, my number one opponent for him would be Yordanis Ugas, right? Because he's still young, still fresh. He's still very, very hungry. Number two would be Austin Trout, right? He's coming down to 147. He's looking for fights. He just recently called out Amir Khan. Number three would be Sergey Lipinets, right? He's in the running for a title. Currently, Jerron Ennis is not even in the top 10 in any of the sanctioned bodies, I don't believe, at least not in the WBO for Terrence Crawford, and I don't believe it's the WBC either. So, you know, I would love to see him, you know, fight Sergey Lipinets, fight Yordanis Ugas. That's going to place yourself, you know, right up there, right in the thick of things to become a world champion, get an opportunity to fight those guys. But first, you need to fight Yordanis Ugas and then Austin Trout, or maybe Austin Trout and then Yordanis Ugas. You proved come out of those fights unscathed, then you're ready for the Terrence Crawfords and the Errol Spencers. Do I believe that he could beat them? I give him a year or two with experience to fight these guys? Oh, absolutely. But right now, currently, from where he stands right now, he's not ready right now. I think the experience factor for Terrence Crawford and Errol Spence would come into play and would be a major factor and would prove to be the difference in the fight. But I love the confidence and I love the mindset of Jerron Boots Ennis, because I do believe he is the future of the welterweight division as long as he could stay there. I think being 5'10" and with a 74-inch arm reach, looks like he's on the verge of being a junior middleweight, 154-pounder, which I believe he'll be a problem for most of them up there as well. So, like I said, how about Austin Trout next? How about Yordanis Ugas after that? And then you could make a case for yourself against the Crawfords and the Spence. And by that time, Crawford and Spence are probably going to have faced off against one another and be undisputed. And if Errol Spence is the winner, he may be heading north to the junior welterweight division. So you may have to see him at 154. And as Terrence Crawford, if he loses to Errol Spence, who knows where he goes from that point on. But I think, you know, you land you beat Austin Trout, then you beat Yordanis Ugas. If you can't land Spence, or by that time, if Errol Spence is undisputed, he was going to vacate the welterweight titles. He's going to move up to junior middleweight. Then now you get to fight a Sean Porter for that belt. You get to fight a Danny Garcia for that belt. You understand? You start to make a name for yourself. And then you're going to see Errol Spence eventually down the line at 154. I don't know if you ever land the opportunity with Terrence Crawford if he loses to Errol Spence, you know, but put yourself in that position. So let's see how this all plays out. He definitely has all the skills to do it. He's a switch. He could switch from southpaw to orthodox. He's very skillful, very athletic. Now, I would say this. I believe that Jerron Ennis is more athletic than both Terrence Crawford and Errol Spence. I believe he has very high skill set. I can't say he has more skills or more ring generalship than them because we haven't seen him in that position where he was in an adverse situation and he had to make adjustments. We haven't seen that, right? The level of opponent don't tell us that. So let's see how this plays out. But I love the confidence in Jerron Boots Ennis, and I would love to see these fights. But first, like I said, step up in competition before you jump up there. So let's see how this all plays out. But that's all I got for y'all. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the bell icon to get all the new notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.